Hey guys, it's Green DJ, and in today's video, I will be reacting to episodes 22 to 24 of Bakuman. So let's go ahead and get started with episode 22, and 3, 2, 1, go. Exactly. I mean, but okay. I get that, but like, what if this isn't gonna go so well for him? He's too cocky. I think if I hadn't gotten this out last week, we would have been on season 2 now, but no. Busy, complicated-ish, and now I am stressed trying to hurry up and get this out. Because I just have this and my Atomai, and then I'll be done. Oh, Fukuda. Just, you know, don't make a big audience commotion, whatever, you know. Yes, all four. Yeah. Yeah, and that's so not fair. At least let him enter the next one and not this one. It's a possibility. But it is, though! Okay, but then hold up. What the fuck mean? What does that mean if it's good? Let's think about this a little fucking quickly. Come on. Besides, he even fucking stated at his last concert, "Oh hey, vote for me." Cheating. Yes. I'm sorry. As do I. Because if they're all pouring their whole selves into it, and this rock star comes and just does a half-assed job and everyone votes for him, that's a little unfair, correct? Yeah, but I don't think Akito and Shido can drop out. It was everything to them. Seriously? Yeah. Let's hope so. See, also, how can we truly say that he's taking manga seriously even if we haven't seen his work? I mean, but hey, at least it's something better than nothing, though, guys. I mean, is it a little necessary, Nisma, as a join? I mean, aren't you a little busy? But it would be nice. Might as well. Nice glasses. Well, damn, Fugura. Don't make me choke on my Jolly Ranch and I can't. Well, of course you're gonna say that. Of course. Yeah, you might as well. Okay, there's a but. Yeah, so just say it. Because they're both that good. I think he thinks that their work is in third. I don't think so, but I get it if he does. Yeah, but what if AZ's personal opinion is right, though? I hope so. It's so stressful. Exactly. Like shit. I mean, hold on, it would be better just to see her live, just saying, duh. Exactly, it can be greater. Speaking of which. Seriously? Finally coming back to this like a week later, I'm so fucking excited to see how this is gonna go. One, two, well, that was one. Two, I really like the fact that, you know, we got to have everyone in a group together, have a meeting and critique everyone's work. But at the same time, of course, you don't want to say too much. I mean, it's very similar to, like, okay, let's say you're in a group full of your friends and you all decide to write your own, like, novella. It could be about anything. And let's say you make it's like a 150 page novella. You all make one each and you all hand each other your novellas, your copies, whatever, and so that you can all read it and it's like that. By the time everybody finishes it, everyone's gonna be so confident and such and being like, oh my god, no, mine is the best, da-da-da, this is that, the third. Because no matter what, it is your work. You are automatically going to say that your work is the best. Even though if you have someone who is this big, popular, fantastic writer and who sits here and says, okay, yes, one of you got three and the third and the other two are tied for first. Of course, but yeah, I want to know who got third and who got tied for first, because that... In a way, it would boost someone's ego. So, like, let's say it was Fukuda, because your girl has a crush on Fukuda, of course. Of course that would boost his ego. Same thing with Aoki. She, her ego will go up. Anybody's ego will go up when you find out that you're tied for first. When it's third, your ego is going to go down. Your confidence is going to go down. And I didn't, at the same time, as much as I wanted to hear who got third and who tied for first, I didn't want to see either Akito or Shido go into a depressive state. With Akito, we've already seen him in a depressive state. And kind of a little bit with Shido at the same time, but not as much as Akito. So I think it would have hurt a little bit more if we possibly got to see that. But at the same time, I kind of want it and such, because there's always a point in time where we've all, no matter what we've done in our lives as a job, a side job, a career, or whatever, we've all gotten depressed about something in our lives. And it takes a toll on us. And next thing you know, you feel like what you're possibly doing isn't fun anymore. And you have to find something new to change it up to make it fun and lively again. And sometimes you have to kind of step away from it, you know, for a little bit. Like me, ever since 2016 of fall, I have been working my ass off doing YouTube. And sometimes I feel like, no, I don't need a break, this is that and third, I can keep going. But I've been taught, like, kind of very, very fairly recently, that sometimes I need a break. Whether I hear this from my mom or some of my subscribers or some of my really close friends, because I am someone who really has a goal and wanting to make YouTube my full-time job, even though I want to draw a really good career at the same time. Sometimes I go a little too hard, too fast, and the next thing you know, I possibly get burned out. I think there was like one time I got burned out, and it just, I had to really step back and be like, hey, I'm taking a break for a week. I'll be back. I know people were upset at me when it came, because the break came out of nowhere, and everybody was like, why are you taking a break? And I remember, like, so many other big YouTubers were talking about it, and I was like, because of burnout. And it happens to all of us and such, and I want to see it, but then at the same time, I don't. But yes, good episode. But go ahead and pause the video, and I'll see you guys in 1 second for episode 23. Okay, episode 23 in 3, 2, 1, go. Yeah, exactly. Because, like, Well, he is. Okay. I should feel a little bit better, but I still might be cold. I don't know. If I have to, I'll take my headphones off and put it on. Yeah. Exactly. Hmm. Seriously? Exactly what I meant. Till we got time for fun. Okay, but have you even started anything? He kind of reminds me of that one character from Nana, I think, Ren. Would you change too? Of course. Of course. Come here. Ow, Cody. Come here. Die. Of course. Mm-hmm. Oh my god, your face. That's what happens when you're determined. No sleep, no food, not just get my shit done. You got this. Exactly. You just focus on you two. have done anything? Kick him out. Kick him out. No. He hasn't done jack-ish. Of course. Oh, he finally finished? God. See, once again, he's too fucking cocky. He's a cocky, arrogant bastard. Oh, well, damn. Trash at him though? Congratulate him? Because that's all what you want. Then what's up? Yeah, I mean, it's artistic and different, but damn it. FUCK. Big FUCK. SHIT. BITCH. That means anything, really. Oh my god. Damn it. God, but okay, hold on, wait, see, we gotta wait until the next episode to figure out what the fuck is about to go down. Like, okay, you know how, once again, going into the overly confident, you know, when you're really confident about something, and you're like, oh yes, this is going to do fine. That's how I feel right now with this situation, but at the same time, I am scared. Everybody did really well. I don't know about a rock star resident, 'cause I mean, don't get me wrong, like his art is good, really good. Kind of gives me like, how how should I say this? Like, a diamond in the rough. Not saying that it's not bad, but it's not good. It's in the middle. I like it for what it is, but comparing it to the other four, the others, I mean, I really have nothing else to say. But yeah, I'm just very, 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 very hella nervous because this could go so many ways. This could go good and this can go bad. But yes, go ahead and pause the video and I'll see you guys in 1 second for episode 24. Okay, episode 24 and 3, 2, 1, go. That fucking Yeah, but it might happen. I'm scared. This is four different people's work, and one of them might win. I mean, still, they're all winners at the end of the day, but, like, one is just that all-time winner. It's just like, oh my god, it's like every freaking, reality TV show competition. Like, oh my god. You know how when you're, like, when you watch a reality TV show competition and you are so excited when it's the first episode and you're just like, okay, like, anybody can win. And then you get closer and closer to the final episode of the season and you see whoever the top 3, 4, 5 are and you're like, I don't know who's gonna win. Like, every... The reality TV show competition that I'm still obsessed with hasn't aired this season because of COVID, and they can't really travel the world because of COVID. But their last season that they filmed like 2-3 years ago and came out last year. I mean, that was complicated. Every season is freaking complicated of that show because when you get closer and closer to the end and you're looking at all these people, you're like, who the freak you think is going to win this money? This is like that. Except harder, because everybody's work is good, and it's like, fuck. Feels better. Excuse me. All three. Jesus. Yeah. But you are. Oh, they might not even actually give you answers until tomorrow. So in the end, everyone wins. I mean, damn. On a hot dog. I'm sorry, I know that's random, but I'm kind of hungry. Oh, this is six. Oh, baby. Yeah, you need to get a load off your chest. Oh. Okay. Like, I'm happy that everybody's the one, but still at the same time, because we don't know what the fuck is about to happen. Like, anything, once again, anything could happen. Oh, God. This is, what can I compare it to? This is like the fucking, okay, as someone who doesn't watch sports, this is like the Super Bowl leading up to it. God, you know. I'm so scared and nervous. And excited, too. So, so excited. This could go really well for all three of them. But at the same time, I don't know. Y'all know I don't. And I hate that. And I want to know so bad. I want to watch the next three episodes. But I don't think I'll be able to do it today. Because I still have one more thing to do before I'm done completely. So either. I don't think I can do it tomorrow either. Because I'm going to be rearranging my room after I get what's his face out. So Sunday literally is the only day I can do it. But hopes and prayers that this works out because I need it to. This is their dream. And when it's their dream, it's also my dream because I want it just as much for them as much as they do. I don't like the fact that this episode is entitled Yes and No. Out of all the things, why would you title it Yes and No? Like, anything can happen. Like, no. Oh my God. Don't do this to me. Like, no. 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 But I need it to be Sunday because I want to know what the hell is going to happen because I think I'm going to watch this first when Sunday comes because officially I don't have anything else to do on Sunday. But yes, I need to know what the fuck is going to happen next. Like, so freaking bad. But other than that, guys, that is my reaction view towards episodes 22 to 24 of Bakemonogatari. If you guys enjoyed it, please give me a like. It really helps me out. Also, subscribe to my channel. I make videos every single day. Join the Matchable Squad. And of course, I will see you guys next Friday for Patreons and next Wednesday, I was about to say, for episodes, the final episode of the first half of season one, and then the next two episodes for the second half of season two. But until then, I will see you guys all next time. Bye.